So, Tenny, if you can, so another thing that is important to talk about, especially in metal and even in classical, the rhythm, the time signature rhythm, groove, all these things are sort of, mixed in together. So, how you use that? So, one thing that we talked about that we'll discuss is one of my favorite songs of yours is a song called Spiral Coma, right? And is it correct that you composed that intro?
Yeah, that intro was really funny because at that time
Okay.
I was listening to a lot of Spiral Architect and like that's an amazing band, Spiral Architect, some Dream Theater and stuff like that back in the day. And
Okay.
I was like, what, okay, like I'm like going through so much to learn this stuff. Like, okay, at least try to learn like all these other bands. Okay, what if we can come up with something interesting, which
Okay.
maybe in about another 15 years somebody can look into or something like that. So
Okay.
Spider Coma is really interesting. That
So
is
so for yeah.
the thing which came up because I was thinking, okay, if people can count just 1, 2, 3, 4, what if we can come up with something which you can't just count, but you just have
Yeah, that
to like
yeah. So for
that's
those of yeah. For those of you who haven't, go check out Spiral Coma. Just listen to at least, the first like 15 seconds of it and see whether you can count it. But it's an amazing riff. So Tenny, if you can just play that first, play it like real time, how it would sound real time with the muting, so that you get the separation of the beats. And then if you can just slowly then guide us through, okay, what your how your the counting pattern and everything is.
Yeah, definitely. So, okay, I'll just give
So
a
first play it, first play it
little
scan, yeah, normal speed with the muting
normal.
play it, then.
Right, okay. So it starts with a 3 count, so it just goes, can you guys see the fret?
That was clear.
So
So
just to explain it, I mean,
yeah, you can explain it, play it slowly and explain how you count it and how the timing is there.
it's easy to understand. So it just starts with like just a 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's in different sections of like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. How you count this section is like this. You just count from 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is the loop of it. Meaning you can't just keep it at a 4. We just have to always count it because if you miss it on one beat, you just fall behind the whole band.
Okay.
It's also a really great example of using 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And if you want to play a 6, let's say a six beat, and playing a 7 as well, because you can't just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, because then there will be a delay. It's an easy
Okay.
way to get to a 7 as well.
Okay.
So easiest way to understand is just
So
always do it. Yeah, it's easier to do it like a
Play
1.
it slowly.
Yeah, I'll do it like slowly. So
Yeah.
see whether you can naturally count this in your own system. It just goes 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 7 yeah, accenting. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So how the accents fall on the first line is different to the second time you play.
Yeah, that's right.
So second time you do like a reverse. So second time around maybe loops, you're playing like a 1, 2, 3. On the 3, we are doing the first accent.
Okay.
So on the first line, 1, 2, 3, the third accent. Yeah, playing it on the second round, you're doing a 1 as the first accent. So it's a little bit harder to explain. So let me just count it once more so that maybe you can get it easier. First round, it goes 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So that third one goes 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Different places we are doing accents and all. It's really, really interesting because
if you can play Masang, that 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, just those up to 1, 2, 3, 4, play the first iteration and the second iteration just for people to see the difference.
Yeah. So I'm playing this after ages also.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's go. First one is 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So it's just like on those accents which I have. But counting is like you need to keep that groove going. Because if you lose the groove and just count, you won't have feel.
Yeah, that's true.
So, it's very important to have feel when you play stuff. Especially when you're playing hot time signatures or like stuff that.
How did you record this? Did you set the metronome as just a tuck, 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 like that? Or how did you do the recording?
Yeah, when we recorded Masan, we couldn't put a metronome. Because on grid, and every time we try to put it to a grid, it jumps. Because there has been nothing, even something like that. And it was just impossible to put it to a metric.
You just did the drum track first to keep that as the guide, or how did you do it?
Yeah, Masha, it was nightmare recording that part, because what we did was we recorded the guitar first. In 2010, we recorded this. So in 2010, we did all guitar takes in one day because we had save time. So what we did was we recorded all the guitars and I layered all the guitars to a metronome. Metronome is just going, I'm just playing with feel, and some areas in metronome, you're going out the metronome and you're coming back up. And what we figured back in the day, Masham, was when you're writing music, that our music sometimes we have like longer lines rather than shorter lines of sections. Okay. So when it's long lines, it comes in from a certain area of the metronome. Once you come back, it's like a long line. Like we come back up like certain 30 seconds or 45 seconds only, we are coming, everybody's coming on to groove again. We kind of got used to it. And it was interesting for us because only we could like gel and actually do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that you all follow that same, must be having the same problem with other songs also, right?
Yes, definitely. Because some of the tracks we had that issue, nowadays, it's very different because now we got our sound cards, we have laptops, we have QPS learning. So now it's more or less, we are like very, very focused on writing like songs and stuff like that. And once in a way, we like to go banana and do some sections and all. But back in the day, we didn't have that luxury. So it was always everything was in the head.